We love our news car.
So will you. I guarantee it.
Pro Wrestling This Week, tonight at midnight on WEEK.
At Indiana State, bird is the word. Eddie Bird, that is. And yes, he's Larry's little brother. But this bird is just learning to fly. 19 points against Bradley in January. The Braves try to ground him today. Live, 25 Sports brings you Bradley Basketball. Today it's homecoming, and the Braves face the Sycamores of Indiana State.
Welcome to Carver Arena on Homecoming Saturday as the Bradley Braves play the Indiana State Sycamores. Hello again, everybody. I'm Mark Strauss, along with Lee Hall, welcoming you to our telecast of the Bradley Brave basketball. And you know, a year ago, the Braves learned a valuable lesson. If you're close to a conference championship, you'd better have that killer instinct. The Braves didn't win the Valley last year, but today, Lee, they have a chance with a victory over the Sycamores to clinch at least a tie for the Valley title.
Well, we talked to them, Mark, about that, and they did learn a valuable lesson. They know they control their own destiny. One thing that will be a little easier, they won't have to hear a Wichita State score here during the game because they play tonight. Of course, Indiana State has struggled all year long, injuries, death to one player, but they have played well. They beat Tulsa, and they've also beaten Wichita State, so they do have the capability to play well.
As you said, Lee, the Braves with their destiny in their own hands, if they win this afternoon and Wichita loses its game to Tulsa tonight, the Braves will be Missouri Valley champions before their regular season finale on Monday. It's also Senior Day here in Peoria, and we'll be back with the Senior Day ceremonies in just a minute.
Has midwinter cabin fever been breathing down your neck? Well, it hasn't. The IRS soon will. Don't let it get the best of you. Spend your refund now while the savings are hot during Team Electronics Cabin Fever Sale. Big savings on the best in audio and video and more. Free basic install on car stereos, free delivery on stereo systems during the Cabin Fever Sale. The Cabin Fever Sale is going on right now at Team Electronics in the Metro Center.
Which Central Illinois law firm has over 65 years combined experience in personal injury cases?
Goldfein and Bowles.
Which law firm represents the largest number of personal injury victims?
Goldfein and Bowles.
Which law firm is the leader in personal injury and workers' compensation awards?
Goldfein and Bowles.
What's the first thing you should do if you're injured?
Call Goldfein and Bowles. There's no charge to discuss your case. Don't settle for less.
During our Whirlpool 100% customer commitment sale, you're going to like our low price.
That's a low price.
And you're going to like the quality and performance of these Whirlpool appliances.
Or they'll make it right or replace it free for up to a year.
Way to go, little buddy.
There's a lot to like now, at the Whirlpool 100% customer commitment sale.
At North Point Video, Audio and Appliance in Peoria and Morton.
WEEK, 25 at 35, Monday at 8.
The Braves and the Indiana State Sycamores, and while this is the final regular season home game at Carver Arena, it is not the final game here because, of course, in a week, the Braves will host the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament, and that home floor advantage should be a big one for them. It is Senior Day in Peoria, and there are seven seniors who will be honored before today's ball game. Bruce Mordini, Len Bertolini, Jerry Thomas, Greg Jones, Donald Powell, Trevor Trimpe, and of course, Hersey Hawkins. And this group of seniors has had perhaps the most interesting 4 years of any class in recent Bradley history.
Well, it seems like it's gone so fast, too. They are a talented bunch. We've watched them grow up over the last 4 years. It really seems impossible that this is their last regular season home game.
They have had ups and downs, of course, the lowest point being when Dick Versace left and the Braves were put on probation, and one of the high points when that man Stan Albeck came in and kept the bottom from falling out. And the entire Braves roster decided to stay in Peoria rather than consider transferring. As I said, it's Senior Day, and so for our Senior Day ceremonies, let's turn it over to our public address announcer here at Carver Arena, Paul Herzog.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the Bradley Bench area, where the university and you, the fans, will help honor seven special athletes and their families on Senior Day 1988. This class has dominated the Missouri Valley Conference for 4 years, compiling a 45-13 regular season record. They have provided thrills, chills, and a championship to the loyal followers in Central Illinois, across the state, and across the country. First, please welcome from Highland Park, Illinois, Bob and Marilyn Mordini. Their son was injured throughout most of his collegiate career, but never gave up trying to help his teammates through numerous comeback attempts. His career high of 10 points came at the best of times in a road victory last season at Illinois State. For his efforts and determination, please thank Bruce Mordini. From Chicago, please welcome Len and Rose Bertolini. Their son was a fan's delight as his delicate passing and shooter's touch lit up the nets many an evening. When a three-point was introduced, many thought it was just for his poetic jump shots. Unfortunately, an injury cut short his senior season, but in character, he went out shooting. Of the 5 three-pointers he tried this year, he made 4 of them. Here's Lenny Bertolini. From Chicago, his parents were able to be here today, but always known as part of the Bradley Street Forwards, a combination of defensive specialist and slam dunk artist. Regarded as one of the best pure athletes to pay for the Braves, he's also saved his best for Illinois State as well. Please thank Jerry Thomas. Also from Chicago, welcome Classy Jones and Jackie Jones. Her son forms the other half of the Street Forward duo. Unlike Jerry Thomas, he saved his best for Southern Illinois and Drake. Throw in a masterful performance in the Palestra in Philadelphia, and you realize what a valuable performer he has become, both as a starter and as a reserve. Here's Greg Jones! All the way from Nowata, Oklahoma, welcome William E. Powell and Gail Hersey. The biggest answer for Bradley's inside game, he's led the Braves in the conference in block shots for the past 3 seasons. Add his roundhouse dunks to the excitement, you have a player who has thrilled the fans at both ends of the court for 4 years. The player has turned more numbers on the kaboom counter than anyone else. 24, Donald Powell. And from not so far away, Havana, Illinois, to be exact, welcome Ronald and Margaret Trimpe. Their son was both the rock of Bradley's lineup and the glue of the team over the past 4 years. He's a nightmare to any opponent zone defense. He also helped the Braves win with his defense, passing, rebounding, and heads-up play. But Wynn should be his middle name. If you count only the games in which he's played, Bradley has won more than 75% of them. For his efforts, thanks, Trevor Trempe. And finally, from Chicago, Hersey Sr. and Laura Hawkins. Leading scorer, the all-time scorer in Bradley history, the number 9 scorer in the NCAA, and the number 3 scorer in the Missouri Valley Conference. He's number 33 in your program, but forever number 1 in your hearts, Hersey Hawkins!
Those 7 players have helped Bradley win 87 games while losing only 32. It's a big day at Carver Arena, and we'll be back with a starting lineup in just a minute.
I'm Mickey Smith. We take Nissan's luxury and performance one step further at Jim Smith Nissan.
Peoria's only Nissan dealer is loaded with new 88 Pulsars at 87 prices. See Jim Smith Nissan's wide selection of sporty Pulsars in stock at great savings now. We're dealing on luxurious Maxima GXEs too. Maxima GXEs and 88 Pulsars at 87 prices.
At Jim Smith Nissan, you know you have a dealer you can trust. Nobody cares for you better than Jim Smith Nissan.
Sometimes there's only one way to do it right, so we did it. Our home needed help, so we brought it to the Pella Window Store, the experts. Beautiful wood windows, new wood doors, sunrooms, skylights. What a great place for ideas. I'm glad we talked to the window experts.
Bring your home to Pella.
The Pella Window Store, 4601 North University, Peoria. Matlock at a special time today at 4:30.
Well, the Braves, well-respected by those who are the so-called experts, ranked 14th by the Associated Press, Sports Illustrated, and UPI, 15th by the Sporting News, and CNN USA Today has them at 18th this week. As for the Missouri Valley Conference standings, well, you can see that nothing is set in stone. The Braves can clinch at least a tie with Wichita State if they win this afternoon's ball game, and then if the Shockers lost to Tulsa tonight, the Braves would be Missouri Valley Conference champions. But Illinois State is still in the running for a position in the upper division. Creighton and Drake are battling for a spot. Southern Illinois at 4-7 is actually in fourth place, not down at number 6. So the Salukis, with a win in their game against Illinois State, could go a long way in finishing in the upper division. A very complicated last couple of days of the season if you're watching the standings.
The way things look now, we could see a rematch of this ball game next Saturday.
That's right, because if the Braves were to win the conference and be seated first in the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament, and Indiana State were to finish last, this would be the first round pairing. And of course, the Braves wouldn't want to lose this game for obvious reasons, but it's also possible that if they were to finish second, or if Tulsa were to finish last and the Braves were to finish first, they could end up playing Tulsa in the first round. And I don't want to get any further into it because it becomes very confusing, but the Braves certainly don't want to meet Tulsa right off the bat in the tournament. That's the one Missouri Valley team that's given them the most trouble this year. They have barely squeaked past the Golden Hurricane on 2 occasions.
This Indiana State club gave them a very good game down in Terre Haute. Bradley ended up winning that one by 11, but they did play well. They held Hersey Hawkins pretty much silent there in the first half. He only scored 6 points down there, so they did a decent job. It'll be interesting to see if they can come anywhere near that on the road today.
And before the ball game, we'll put Paul Herzog back to work one more time for our starting lineups.
And now let's meet the starting lineups for today's Missouri Valley Conference game featuring the Sycamores of Indiana State and your Bradley Braves. At a forward for the Sycamores, a 6'6 freshman from French Lick, Indiana, 42, Eddie Byrne. And for Bradley, a 6'7 senior from Havana, Illinois, number 40, Trevor Tempe. The other forward for Indiana State, a 6'5 senior from Michigan City, Indiana, 24, Deion Campbell. And for Bradley, a 6'6 senior from Chicago, 32, Greg Jones. At center for the Sycamores, a 6'8 sophomore from Ondo State, Nigeria, number 41, Alofimi Akinola. And for Bradley, a 6'8 sophomore from Springfield, Illinois, 53, Luke Jackson. At a guard for Indiana State, a 6'1 sophomore from Freeport in the Bahamas, 15, Richie Adderley. And for Bradley, a 5'11 junior from Chicago, number 12, Anthony Manuel. Another guard for Indiana State, a 6 foot junior from Saginaw, Michigan, 21, Jimmy Holiday. And for Bradley, a 5'11 senior, All-American from Chicago, 33, Hersey Hawkins. The coaches for Indiana State in his third season, Ron Green. For Bradley, the Bradley class of 1955 trying for his 600th career coaching victory today in his second season at Bradley, Stan Albeck.
The officials for this afternoon's ball game, all Missouri Valley officials from left to right, Willie Sanchez, Ron Burkholz, and Mike Brady. The Braves are 21-4. They are 10-2 in the Missouri Valley Conference. And in first place, the Sycamores are 7-19, 3-10 in the Missouri Valley Conference, and in last place. And they haven't won a road game since December of 1986.
It's been a dry spell. We mentioned at the top of the game that they had wins over Tulsa and over Wichita State. Both of those, of course, coming at home. They'll have a little bit tougher time of it here today against Bradley. These seniors are very determined, and the rest of the team is as well. They don't want to let it get away from them like they did last year.
Our opening tip between Luke Jackson and Olafemi Akinola. Willie Sanchez puts the ball in the air, and we are underway as the Braves win the tip, and let's see if they can score first here on Homecoming Saturday. Trevor Trimpe holds the ball high to Anthony Manuel. Now Hawkins launches a three. Yes. The nation's leading scorer is the first scorer in today's ball game. And a steal for the Hawk. I think you read that article in Sport Magazine about him, and he's been going crazy ever since on defense. Jackson inside, fakes the shot, and then makes a poor pass. And Eddie Byrd comes away with a rebound, and he's sporting goggles, looking more like Kareem than his older brother. But he looks like Larry right there with the three-pointer. Eddie Byrd was a Proposition 48 victim last year, but he didn't lose eligibility because Larry Byrd paid his tuition.
Eddie might have lost a little bit of that competitive edge sitting out last year. Ron Green said that he had a little trouble coming back and getting back into the flow of a game. By sitting out for that year, you kind of lose your competitiveness, but he's found it here in the last few games.
Here's Byrd cutting through the lane, scooping and missing. Luke Jackson there to clear the boards. Manuel ahead to Trippick, pulls up at the stripe, and hit misses. Jackson lays it in on the rebound and count the basket. Seven rebounds a game for Luke Jackson, and you can see him maturing with every game. Ron Green didn't think the basket should have counted. Ron Burkholz, however, did. It's been a rough year for that man. And a technical. A technical called on the Indiana State bench, apparently against Green. So he'll get two shots for that. He converts on the three-point play, and you know who'll take the technical free throws, Hersey Hawkins.
Hawkins is shooting more free throws.
What a long year for Ron Green.
Mark, I think they called two technicals because Hawk is going to shoot four free throws. I'm not exactly sure why, unless Ron Green might have come out of the coach's box. You mentioned it has been a frustrating year for him. He said if he hadn't had the experience of coaching for many years, had he been a younger man, he might be looking for something else to do. They've had a lot of injuries. They've had a bad season. And, of course, last week ago yesterday, they lost Ratimi Alaikajah, who died in practice.
Green can only watch. And the Hawks splits the four free throws down the middle. It's 8-3, 1:29 into the ball game. Bradley on top. Here's the inbound to Greg Jones. Cross-court Hawkins. They say a Bradley player touched it last, and the Sycamores will take over.
Indiana State opening up the ball game in a zone, and it looks like they are bringing a man out on Anthony Manuel to try and contest that pass and keep him from getting the ball into Hersey.
Here's Bird outside Richie Adderley, around the horn Akinola. The drive by Deion Campbell, but he walked. The Sycamores, another one of those Missouri Valley teams that's very deliberate on offense. Adderley working on Manuel. Trimpy open for the three, doesn't take it. Alley-oop to Luke. With Jim Less in the audience this afternoon, Anthony Manuel shows him what he picked up while being his understudy.
Indiana State trying to run their front men on that zone out and pressure Anthony. They didn't do a very good job that time.
And a whistle from Ron Burkholz. The foul will be against Bradley's Greg Jones. And that's the first foul of the ball game on the Braves, who lead it 10-3. Deion Campbell with the inbound to Akinola, now to Bird in front of the Bradley bench, drives past Jones, pulls up, and hits.
He's performing rather acrobatically, just like his brother here in the early going. He had a hanging scoop, falling down shot in the lane that didn't go in, and then that time he fell down.
Here's the Hawk. Now Manuel drives baseline. The rainbow is no good off the back iron. Hawkins is fouled. And you can count the basket. 7 points already for Hersey Hawkins.
Anthony Manuel's had a little bit of trouble shooting lately. He's only about 28% in his last five or six games. And this is the man that Sport Magazine says has no explosiveness off the floor. You alluded to that article earlier. They didn't have too many nice things to say about Hersey or the Braves.
Now a steal by Hawkins. He scores and he's fouled. And for the third time in the ball game, the Braves have an opportunity to convert on a three-point play. And they've done that without a shot from Trevor Trimpy. This one doesn't go, though. A 10-point bulge in favor of the Braves. It's 15-5. 3 minutes gone. And Adderley dribbled it out of bounds. Rob Bickers into the ballgame, number 10 for Indiana State. He's a freshman from Kingston, Maine. Working on Manuel. A bullet inside to Jones. Manuel averaging just under 12 assists per game. A textbook version of it there.
Bradley not having any trouble picking apart the Indiana State zone so far.
Manuel picks the pocket of Bird. And he is fouled on the play. And one of the Indiana State players went out of bounds hard. Adderley went out of bounds behind the still photographers under the baseline.
Well, Anthony does this so often. He'll come up and help out defensively on a man and pick him clean. He does that a lot going down on the inside and picks the big man.
Adderley's up. And Akinola with his second foul puts Anthony Manuel at the line. Shooting 79% from the charity stripe. Braves with a 12-point lead. Make it 13. Manuel sinks them both. Here's that pressure again.
And it's worked well so far. A couple of turnovers in a row. This time they break it.
Inside to Campbell, a bad pass by Akinola, stolen by Trippi, then almost, and is re-stolen by Indiana State. So a reprieve for the Sycamores, who don't want to dig a deeper hole. They're already down by 14.
They haven't taken very good care of the ball so far either. A lot of that is Bradley's fault. Bradley's been forcing the turnovers.
A scramble for the ball, won by Hawkins. He hands to his running mate, Manuel. Back to Hawkins. Manuel with the three. It's 22-5.
If it wasn't for Eddie Bird, we'd be pitching a shutout right here.
He has all five Sycamore points. Akinola outside. Puts the dribble down on Jackson, leans in and misses. Greg Jones is fouled by Akinola on the rebound, and he already has three fouls against him. This is a kid who used to play with Akeem Olajuwon on the Nigerian national team. And next year we'll have the opportunity to play with his brother, Taju Olajuwon, who is sitting out this year as a Proposition 48 victim with the Sycamores. We're going to take a break. The Braves with a 17-point lead early in the game.
For years, the people of Central Illinois have been telling you about Pekin New Car Dealers.
We looked in Canton and Peoria and Pekin and finally decided to buy our car at Pekin.
We negotiated for the very best price.
Isn't it time you found out for yourself? For the best selection, best service before and after the sale, and the best price, look no further than the Pekin New Car Dealers. They have what you're looking for, and they have it for less.
What's an estimated bill?
How do I read my meter?
Where does my water come from?
How do you treat the water?
How much water do I pump daily?
Is our water sick?
What causes rusty water?
Why do I pay for fire protection?
How do I get new service?
What if I move?
What number do I call for emergency service?
Stop.
Everything you ever wanted or needed to know about your water is in Illinois American Water Company's new customer information guide. And best of all, they're free. To get your copy, stop by Illinois American Water Company's Peoria or Pekin office. Or you can call and they'll send you one right out. Illinois American Water Company's customer information guide. Get your free copy today.
Well, Rory, we've been here 6 weeks now, and it's fantastic how people are responding.
Right, Bruce, and I gotta believe that's people reacting to that Veldy name for giving the best price and the best service.
And that applies all the way through, from the minute they walk through the door to when they first bring in that new car for service.
At Veldy Oldsmobile Cadillac, we'd like to make a promise to everybody that we are committed to your total satisfaction in everything that we do.
It's sales, parts, and service. Come see us. Remember, at Veldy Oldsmobile Cadillac, we're going to change the way you buy a car forever.
The Stan Albeck Show, Sundays, only on WEEK.
The North Point Video Bradley Player of the Game will be named later this afternoon. North Point Video will make a donation in the name of that player to Bradley University's General Scholarship Fund. The Braves leading 22-5 in the early going, and it's as if there wasn't enough pressure on Eddie Byrd already. Guess where Indiana State's first road game was this year? In Boston. 25 newspaper reporters and 8 television stations showed up to cover the Sycamores game with Boston University in Boston, and Byrd was 0 for 11 from the field, and brother Larry was in the audience. I think he's come out of his shell since then, though. He's averaging 15 points per game. And now a steal by Byrd. Vickers with the pass to Adderley. Number 52, Darren Lyles in the ball game. The freshman underneath. Fakes, fires, and hits.
Made a good cut to the basket that time. Luke was out top guarding him and got lost in the shuffle.
In and out for Manuel. Here's Adderley. To Vickers. Picked up by Hawkins immediately. Darren Lyles holds it high. And now they'll slow it down. Adderley holding up a clenched fist indicating a set play. Donald Powell will check in shortly, the senior from Nevada, Oklahoma. Byrd with the fake. Jones with the foul. That's the second on Greg. And now Luke Jackson will be replaced by Donald, who has been on a tear. In his last 5 games, he's averaging 18 points and shooting 65% from the field.
And you see his rebounding totals go down a little bit, and I think that's because he is scoring more. He's concentrating more on putting the ball in the basket.
Indiana State has only taken 6 shots, and 4 of them are by Eddie Byrd. They'll work that clock, but they're down 22-7. And we have 13:57 to play in the half. Manuel with another steal. To Hawkins. A dozen for number 33 already. He came into this ball game only 202 points behind the Missouri Valley Conference's all-time scoring leader, Oscar Robertson. He has a legitimate chance to pass the Big O. The Braves with another game Monday and a possibility of 3 games in the MVC tournament, and of course a shoe-in for the national tournament with the NCAA. Powell lost the ball.
I think you're going to see Hersey's leadership really come through here toward the end of the season. The other night after the Tulsa game and talking to him, he said, there was no way I was going to let us lose that game. And if I have to do it myself the rest of the way, I will. I mean, he's going to take charge, and I think we will see a lot more of that, even more than we've seen so far this year.
He did it against Tulsa, and he did a number on Illinois State late in the game when he went one-on-one with anyone who wanted to accommodate him.
And I'm not just talking about scoring points either. He blocked Tracy Moore's shot there at the final minute of the Tulsa game. Got an outlet pass to Jerry Thomas, and that pretty much sealed the ball game.
Jones on the run. It's good, it counts, and he was fouled on the play. The foul on Byrd, his second.
Ron Green is seeing a different game here than he saw in Terre Haute. Bradley was unable to get out on the break at all down in Terre Haute.
Yeah, it was a 31-30 Bradley lead at halftime. The Braves nearly have 31 points now. Hawkins fights for the rebound. Bullets one inside to Powell, but it was touched by a blue jersey. And the Braves will still have it as Jerry Thomas checks in for Greg Jones.
We'll be talking with Greg's mother coming up at halftime, along with a few other parents here on Senior Day, homecoming day.
Here's the Hawk with a 3. Little Rob Vickers there to collect the carom and rush it up the floor in a hurry. Lost the ball. Manuel takes over. Now the Braves put it in high gear to Powell. Jerry Thomas misses. And Vickers clears the boards again.
Like a tennis match out there right now.
Here's Powell inside, stolen by Campbell, but Powell was hammered on the play. And we'll have a foul on the Sycamores. Let's see who Ron Burkholz points to. Deion Campbell, number 24. There were several blue jerseys there. Lyles fouled him before Campbell did, I think.
Well, Donald backs in like that and gets good position. So he'll draw a lot of contact. The turnover by Rob Vickers started all that going back and forth up and down the floor. He doesn't turn the ball over very much. He only averaged a turnover a game in his senior year of high school. He only turned the ball over once against Bradley against some pretty intense pressure down in Terre Haute.
Powell with the free throw. Now needs only 26 points to join Bradley's 1,000 career point club. It's on the way. It's in the bucket. And it's 28-7 in favor of Bradley. Indiana State scored 2 points since the last time out.
Hi, this is Stan Allback, and this is my man for the best car deals in the Peoria area. Bruce Sowers at Veldy Ford and Veldy Lincoln Mercury.
Thanks, Stan. We've got the best selection of new and used cars and trucks at the lowest prices right here at Veldy Ford and Veldy Lincoln Mercury. If you think about it, why would you want to go anywhere else? Come in and join the Veldy team today.
Bradley and Veldy, the two hottest teams in Central Illinois.
And remember, if he can't beat your best deal, he'll give you the car free. Just tell him Stan sent you.
There goes Doris, my next door neighbor and practically my best friend. Every time I see her, I can't help but think of her accident. She was in the hospital for weeks, and on top of that, once she got out, she had to hire somebody to help her with the kids, and none of it was her fault. If it weren't for Joe Jansen, she would have been wiped out. He knew exactly how to help her. It was a horrible time for her, but thanks to Jansen, money was the least of her worries. I sure don't mean to look on the dark side, but it's nice to know there's a Jansen out there.
A Peoria success story tonight on American Dreamers.
The parents of Percy Hawkins. And as you look at them, this Bradley basketball telecast is protected by broadcast rights granted by Bradley University and the Missouri Valley Conference. Any rebroadcast or other use without the express written consent of WEEK-TV and Bradley University is prohibited. And Mr. and Mrs. Hawkins has a scrapbook that's getting fatter all the time. Percy with a dozen points in the first half, and that gives him 900 this season. He has a chance for 1,000. I think it's a good chance. He needs only one more century mark to go. Bird with the fake, and he goes up without the ball, but he was fouled by Jerry Thomas.
Boy, Eddie's learned a lot from his brother. He's got that good head fake, and he just goes right by guys who probably are quicker than he is. A lot of savvy. Ron Green says that Eddie has the potential to be a pretty good college player, but one thing he needs to do is learn to let the game come to him, like Percy does, not force things. That's something he's been guilty of here in his freshman season.
He's had a good freshman season. He's one of the top 10 freshman scorers in the country. And last foul on Trevor Trimby, not Jerry Thomas, as I had mentioned. So now that we've got you straight, we're back to action.
Indiana State's gone to man-to-man. Richie Adderley on Hawk. He did a good job on him in the first game.
Campbell forces the turnover. Adderley drives the basket, lays it up. Lyles couldn't hang on to the rebound, and then Hawkins went chasing after the loose ball and took it out of bounds with him. Lyles on Powell. And the Sycamores miss another one from close in. Here's Thomas ahead of the field.
He'll make a living doing that. That's what he played in high school for, Cassie Russell's brother. He does it just about as well as anyone.
Bird runs over Anthony Manuel, and that's three on Eddie Bird. He may have to come out of the ball game, although
If he does, I'm not sure what Ron Green will be waiting for, because I don't think this one's going to be close down the stretch if he's not in there for a while.
Well, Anthony had been setting up, we noticed in the full court pressure a little earlier, he'd been setting up and trying to pick up a charge.
He picked it up. There are still skid marks on his backside.
Yeah, he'll be feeling that one in the morning, you better believe it. Eddie hit him at a pretty good pace.
Bird racking up the fouls and seven of Indiana State's 9 points so far.
Ron Green's expression pretty much says it all for this season.
Ron Cheatham into the ball game, a 6'4 sophomore from Paris, Illinois. Green thought he was the Sycamores' most improved player at the end of last season. Unfortunately, most of his teammates are not back with him. And Green had to start from scratch for his second year in a row. Although I'm not sure he liked the makeup of his ball club last year. He didn't think the personalities were the kinds that he wanted.
Well, he's got the nucleus for a good ball club of the future. As you mentioned earlier, he's got Elijah Wise's little brother.
Ow, with a sparkling dunk. Rejection.
Get up on that one.
Here's Cheatham, open on the baseline, and he's off the mark. Foul against both hands on this one. Thomas ahead of the field again.
He's saying goodbye in a big way.
Right about now, the Sycamores would like to say goodbye.
Well, Ryan Green said if he could get out of here with an 11-point loss like they had in Terre Haute, he'd take it and run. He was afraid of this. He was afraid that they would, Bradley would come back and really pound on him like they did last year. And so far, it's been like a prophet.
Darren Drew. Darren Lyles is fouled by Donald Powell. And Paul Wilson checks into the ball game, averaging 5.8 points per game. The junior from Lorain Catholic in Lorain, Ohio, replacing Trevor Trippett. That's the more photogenic part of Mo McCone. Lyles is from Alabama, where he was an all-state selection, and he throws up a brick. 34-10 is the score. Bradley on top with 9:30 to play in the first half.
Well, the zone didn't work for Indiana State. The man-to-man hasn't been much better.
Powell up over Lyles, and this time Lyles returns the favor. He was fouled by Donald on the other end of the floor, and this time he fouls Powell and sends Donald to the line.
Donald will give Mr. Lyles a pretty good lesson in posting up down low. Leans in and gets that shot off.
One more coming for number 24, and it's good. Vickers dribbles past Manuel into the front court. Here's Campbell to Vickers. Adderley from the foul line, it's good.
Good pick that time by Lyles to free him up.
Here's the Hawk. Three blue jerseys around him, gets off the pass to Thomas, who's fouled by Campbell. And what makes Ron Green's job even harder this year is the fact that his team just doesn't go very deep. They have 10 players on the squad with some experience this year, and they've just added a player by the name of Steve Crandall a few games ago. But he has very limited experience and probably won't see much action the rest of the way.
Now, that makes three walk-ons for Indiana State. Larry Bush, a senior, had a stress fracture in his foot. He only played six games. He's out for the year.
Jerome Steinbeck, a junior, has missed most of the season with mononucleosis and other injuries. And then, of course, the untimely death of Rutimi Olakajaw last week. Really struggled.
Hawkins called for the foul. But with a 24-point lead, he doesn't waste any energy arguing with Willie Sanchez.
That's five team fouls against the Braves, by the way, who are already in the bonus situation.
Man-to-man full court pressure here by Bradley.
Here's Vickers. Open for the three. And the Sycamores have surpassed Percy Hawkins' total of 12 points.
But not for long.
Nope. Nope. 15 for the Hawks, 15 for Indiana State, 39 for the Braves. Vickers, another three, got it. He's a pretty good three-point shooter. He averages 43%. Alley-oop to Hawkins, and he came very close to taking a tumble there.
Well, they are really finding some gaps.
Look at that score. And we have 7:42 to play in the first half.
So sure Ron Green might not just head for the bus at halftime.
I'll tell you what, he may cancel their reservations here for next week. Another three-pointer for Vickers.
Better bring that guy along. That's three in a row.
9 points for Vickers, and he's scoring with Eddie Byrd on the bench because Byrd has those three fouls. They've cut it to 20. Rebound Campbell and a whistle. It's against the Braves. Mike Brady says it's on Jerry Thomas.
Now the important thing for Bradley to do is not get lulled to sleep here. They've had big leads in the past and let teams get back into it. Going into the tournament, you don't want to let that happen. You want to bury a team.
Why the big rush?
I've got to get to University Ford.
What's your hurry?
University Ford.
And you?
University Ford. Why is everybody rushing to University Ford? People have discovered this really is the best place to buy a new or used car or truck.
Get a $2,400 discount on this Taurus GL four-door sedan right now at University Ford.
At University Ford, you're always a winner.
Thanks, David.
Brown's Sporting Goods has hundreds of super fitness values to help you shape up and save. The Weslo Relay 880 treadmill has all the most wanted features, including variable speed adjustment, a 10-function work center that includes time, speed, distance, and a 2-function pulse monitor, plus a gas-assisted incline adjustment. A complete system for only $499.88. You save $200. For fitness, it's Brown's.
Brown's Sporting Goods, for the games you play.
Matlock at a special time today at 4:30.
Bradley by 20, and Percy Hawkins already has 17 points lead.
Well, this is a great way for him to go out in his final regular season game here at home. One of the more creative give and go plays you'll ever see. Boy, Adderley did a really good job down in Terre Haute on Hawk, but he just got turned around there. And that was something that the coaches told Hawk to try and do in the last huddle. They said try and back cut on him, and that time it worked perfectly.
Once again, the firm of Hawkins and Manuel teaming up there. Indiana State with the ball, Bradley with a 20-point lead. And the Braves apply the pressure anyway. He said they don't want to get too comfortable. I don't think they are. Vickers in and out.
Can't hit those tough shots.
Manuel's pass for Thomas was deflected by a Sycamore player. And the maintenance folks here at Carver Arena are breathing a sigh of relief. they have their work cut out for them. They have an 8:30 hockey game here tonight. And after the game, the Chiefs Club has a raffle, so they'll be in the building for another 20 minutes when it's over. Hawkins with 19 points. Larry Bird is only 60 away. He's number two on the Missouri Valley Conference all-time list.
Now, I'd say he's going to be replaced pretty quickly. Really going out on a limb on that one.
You're a regular riverboat gambler.
Yeah, that's me.
6:15 left to go in the half. Adderley in a crowd to Lyles. Could put a piece of paper under his feet. That's about as high as he jumps. Now a steal. Vickers drives on Hawkins and is blocked. Loose ball. Campbell recovers. Adderley launches the three and it's good.
They've been popping that from outside. Slowly got that lead down under 20 now.
Inside Powell, quick turnaround move, and he scores.
Tunnel's done a really good job so far taking advantage of Lyles on the inside. We've got to keep an eye on him defensively, though. Lyles, you can guard him with a sawhorse. He's so slow, but he just kind of moves around and takes up some space and seems to find an opening.
Vickers and Adderley, the guards. Cheatham and Campbell the forwards and Lyles the center.
Sycamores burning a little clock.
Here's Adderley with the scoop. And a nice little move by Richie Adderley. He's from the Bahamas. Not the same scenery in Terre Haute. Hawkins with the acrobatic move. It didn't fall, but he was fouled by Deion Campbell and he'll go back to the free throw line as Luke Jackson checks in for Donald Powell. Almost like the move against the Golden Hurricane the other night.
You know how good a guy is when you see a shot go up like that and you expect it to go in.
That's three fouls on Campbell, by the way. Bird also has three. Campbell stays in there. And Akinola has three. 20 points for Hersey Hawkins. His average is 35 and a half. I think Rox Buckland's here today just to keep the crowd from falling asleep.
It sounds like everybody's nodded off. Can't hear any snoring, but...
Foul against the Braves, and Jerry Thomas racks up his second. 24-1-1. So Campbell at the line, where he's shooting only 51%. He's a senior from Michigan City, Indiana. Thomas blows the layup. Adderley back the other way. A little English on the ball. 9 points for Adderley. And Indiana State cuts it to a 47-30 ball game with 4 minutes to play in the half. Manuel with the fall away. Vickers with his third defensive rebound. Here's Cheatham, fakes right, goes left, drives on Thomas, but he charged. So Cheatham is called for the foul. Trimpe takes a spot on the floor. And we have a timeout as we take a look at that charging foul on Indiana State's Ron Cheatham. We'll be right back.
For years, the people of Central Illinois have been telling you about Pekin New Car Dealers.
As a woman, it's tough to shop for a car. I feel I'm being taken a lot of times, and I don't think that happened at the dealer in Pekin.
I saved a couple $1,000 at Pekin New Car Dealers.
Isn't it time you found out for yourself? For the best selection, best service before and after the sale, and the best price, look no further than the Pekin New Car Dealers. They have what you're looking for, and they have it for less.
Starting your own business, whatever the size, isn't easy. It takes hard work, time, and money.
And that's why I bank at the First National Bank of Peoria. They made it their business to understand my business, and I like that in a bank.
Whether you need a loan, checking or savings account, or employee benefits plan, Peoria's First Bank has all the services you need to make your business grow.
No matter what size your business, you're sure to get results. The First National Bank of Peoria. We'd like to talk business with you.
Join Tom McIntyre, Christine Zach, and Bill Houlihan as they take a retrospective look at 35 years of television in Peoria on WEEK 25 at 35. Monday night at 8, just before the Bradley Southern Illinois game, right here on WEEK. It took 11 and a half minutes for Indiana State to crack double figures this afternoon. But in the last 6 minutes, they've scored 20 points and they've cut the gap to 17 at 47-20. 47-30, I'm sorry. I won't be doing my taxes this year. Of course, I'll have someone do it for me.
You need some help with that?
The Braves turn it over. Bird is still on the bench with three fouls. He's their leading scorer, but Cheatham cans the deuce there. And they're within 15. No good. Trimpe fights for the rebound, and he's fouled.
That's really amazing that Indiana State has come back with Eddie Bird on the bench. There you get a look at him. Give Indiana State some credit. Bradley's missed some shots and turned the ball over. Good effort here by Trevor.
Tell you, Willie Sanchez didn't have to call this one. There were 10,000 people calling it for him. Trimpe misses the free throw, his first free throw attempt in 14 games. The last time he attempted a free throw was against this team in Terre Haute. So he's come full circle. It's only his 11th free throw attempt of the year. He just doesn't get in a position where he's going to be fouled very much when he's out on the perimeter. Another three-pointer for Indiana State. That is the fourth by Vickers.
There's part of the nucleus of the future for Indiana State. Good shooting guard. He handles the ball well, too.
Hawkins fouls Adderley as he goes up.
Good pick by Akinola. Really contained Hawk, got Adderley open that time.
Adderley with a 13-point outing against the Braves when the two men at Terre Haute from the Henry Carr School of Free Throw Shooting.
I was going to say, shades of Henry Carr.
Seen a few players try variations on that.
It's all part of getting in a rhythm, whatever you're comfortable with.
Turns that ball and holds it up like it's a trophy. Jackson with the pull-up jumper. And another whistle. I think this one's on the Braves. And if it's on Thomas, it's his third. It is. So Greg Jones will take JT's spot on the floor. Greg Jones.
And with the Sycamores in the bonus situation, Otto Bibiancanola will go to the free throw line where he's shooting only 42%. He is from Nigeria. Thomas on the bench with 7 points. And this would cut the deficit to 11. And with 2:07 to play, the Sycamores can get in this ballgame. It does.
Well, they're a no-give-up team. Ron Green was telling me last night in practice that the character of this team is the building block of the future, not their talent. He's told them that. They don't give up, no matter what kind of adversity they face.
Big defensive series here, but Manuel throws up the rainbow and assures the Braves of coming back down the floor with the ball the next time in double digits. Or at least with a lead of double digits. Vickers would love to get open for another three. He's got four of them. And Jackson fouls Ron Cheatham on his way to the basket. Jimmy Holiday makes his first appearance, the 6-foot junior from Saginaw, Michigan. The hometown hockey team here tonight for the game with the Rivermen at 8:30. I don't think Jimmy will be staying for that, but we'll plug the game anyway. Cheatham misses the free throw. Manuel comes away with a loose ball. .15 to go on the half as Manuel spins, shoots, and misses. Akinola with the rebound, and the Sycamores have a chance to cut the lead to 9 and to 8 if this fella, Rob Vickers, can can a 3.
You can bet Anthony's going to do his best to stay pretty close to him.
Inside to Akinola, blocked by Hersey Hawkins. He saved the ball, but he stepped on the end line, and it'll belong to Indiana State. That's the fellow that Sport Magazine said couldn't play defense.
And has no explosiveness off the floor.
Yeah, I guess maybe he couldn't play it against Michael Jordan, but he does a pretty good job against everybody else.
No.
This is Brian Williamson checking in for Akinola. Williamson's a 6'9 senior from Iola, Kansas. Here's Holiday inside to Williamson, who just checked in, a bad pass. 3-on-1.
There's a pick-me-up the Braves need going into the locker room. They haven't gotten out on the break the last 4 or 5 minutes or so. That's a big boost right there.
At halftime, the folks from North Point Video will be presenting a check to the Bradley University General Scholarship Fund, honoring all the North Point Video players of the game that we have named this season. Here's Lyles with the hanging shot, and he doesn't hang very high, believe me. He's fouled by Jackson, and that draws some bad reviews. With only 2 seconds left to go in the half.
Homicone still offering his opinion on the sideline.
So Lyles goes to the free throw line with Indiana State down by 13. No good. Jones with the baseball pass, and it's not even close. And Bradley, which once led by 20, will head to the locker room at halftime, leading Indiana State 53-40.
This is Bert Convy of Win, Lose, or Draw, congratulating WEEK-TV on 35 years of knowing what matters. Happy anniversary.
Truck buyers, they're back at S&K Chevrolet's got them. Probably the largest selection in Central Illinois. New 88 Chevy S10. You know, we almost sold out in December, but now, what color do you want? Take your pick today at just $65.78. But look at this payment, $99 a month. Illinois with factory cash back and special option package savings, you can save as much as $2,500 on new S10s. As much as $3,000 on extended cabs. So put the family in the trade. We'll see you here at the talk of the town. S&K Chevrolet in Peoria.
If you're a computer owner, and who isn't today, here's your support team. CBM. CBM Computer Center. Serving you with the best products, people, and ongoing support. CBM has it all. Quality product, service, and expertise. You won't get sold, then left out in the cold. CBM. All you need to remember about computers.
Bring your dreams to life with Pella wood windows and beautiful new Pella wood doors.
Bring your home to Pella.
Whatever you dream of, from a sunny sunroom to a kitchen bay, we'll help bring your dreams to life. Talk to the window experts.
Bring your home to Pella.
The Pella Window Store, 4601 North University, Peoria.
It's our silver anniversary at River Oaks Dodge, and we want to thank you for 25 successful years. We special ordered from the Dodge Division 125 new cars, caravans, and pickups, all with giant customer cash rebates. Save $4,025 on conversions or $2,025 on pickups or $1,525 on Daytonas. Every vehicle in our inventory has been marked down during our anniversary sale. At River Oaks Dodge, we don't say we're low price, we prove it.
We've got the team!
1801 West Pioneer Parkway, Peoria.
In February of 1953, a new era began in Central Illinois. For the first time ever, it was possible to see entertainment on that new device called television. This is Tom McIntyre. Join me this week on Live at 5, News 25, and Nightside as News 25 takes a retrospective look at the area's first glimpse of WEEK-TV. Experience the excitement of the early days of television on WEEK, 25 at 35. This week on Live at 5, News 25 at 6, and Nightside.
Matlock at a special time today at 4:30.
We'll return to Carver Arena and the second half of today's game after these words from our sponsors.
Well, if it isn't the little body with the hot karate.
It's Karate Kid's Pat Morita with Dom DeLuise.
Tonight at 6:30 on WEEK.
Welcome to Peoria Toyota Volvo.
I suppose you're going to try to sell me a new Toyota. I'm busy and I don't need a lot of chit-chat. The first thing you're going to tell me is that Toyota's reputation for quality is legendary. And then you're going to tell me Toyota's high-tech engineering makes driving so much more enjoyable. And I'm sure you'll talk about the Toyota touch when it comes to service. Will you talk me into it? I'll take it.
Who could ask for anything more?
How long does it usually take to have your income tax return prepared? A week? 2 weeks? Even longer? In most cases, you will have it ready to send the very same day when you take it to Sharp Income Tax Service. Sharp is locally owned and operated. Get your maximum refund plus fast, friendly, professional service at Sharp Income Tax Service. Sterling Plaza, Peoria. Town Center 1, East Peoria.
A lot goes into this one little glass.
I'm Mickey Smith. We take Nissan's luxury and performance one step further at Jim Smith Nissan.
Peoria's only Nissan dealer is loaded with new 88 Pulsars at 87 prices. See Jim Smith Nissan's wide selection of sporty Pulsars in stock at great savings now. We're dealing on luxurious Maxima GXEs too. Maxima GXEs and 88 Pulsars at 87 prices.
At Jim Smith Nissan, you know you have a dealer you can trust. Nobody cares for you better than Jim Smith Nissan.
Siskel and Ebert, Sunday nights at 11:30 on WEEK.
With Lee Hall, Mark Strauss at Carver Arena, where later this afternoon, North Point Video's Bradley Player of the Game will be named, and North Point Video will make a donation in the name of that player to Bradley University's General Scholarship Fund. Later on at halftime, the North Point Video folks will be presenting a check to the Bradley Scholarship Fund in honor of all the players of the game from this season. At halftime, it's Bradley 53 and Indiana State 40. The Braves got out to a huge lead, but the Sycamores have been able to chip away and at least make it a ball game before going to the locker room.
Bradley did a good job getting out on the break. Their defense really caused a lot of turnovers by Indiana State there early in the game. But give Indiana State some credit. They came out. Vickers has really been shooting the three well. That's probably what's gotten them back in the game. Bradley has missed a few shots, and that's allowed Indiana State to come down, set up, run a little time off the clock, and get the game more at their pace like they did down in Terre Haute. They really did a good job down at Indiana State of controlling the tempo of the ball game. They really haven't done that today, but there in the last 5-6 minutes of the first half, they really did a better job, and that's why they cut down the lead. It's only 13 at halftime.
And they've done a lot of this without Eddie Bird, who midway through the first half went out with three fouls. He's their leading scorer in Missouri Valley Conference play. He's averaging 20 points per game, and he's on the bench with 3 fouls and only 7 points, and they've been able to stage this comeback mostly without him.
It's really amazing because Eddie Bird leads Indiana State in just about everything but going to the water cooler. He's in about 10 categories. The only negative one is turnovers, but that's because he's taken the ball to the hoop so much. And that's something that he's done well here in the first half when he's played. We might see a little bit more of that in the second half. He's picked up a lot from his brother. I'm really impressed with his head fakes and hustle and diving on the floor, falling down and making the acrobatic shot.
Meanwhile, 21 points for Hersey Hawkins in the first half, and that leaves him only 58 points behind Eddie Bird's brother, who is second on the Missouri Valley Conference's all-time scoring list. 53-40 in favor of the Braves. And right now, let's take a listen to our friends at Bradley.
I'd say some of the individuals have been most influential in my life since I've come to Bradley have been the faculty. Not only have I had the opportunity to get to know them inside the classroom, but outside the classroom, through advisory roles or just through friendship roles. They've given me knowledge both academically and personally, and I've gained a lot of insight through them about life in general, and I think that they've been most influential because of this. I'd say one of the most, not necessarily secure, but outstanding things that has happened to me since I've come to Bradley is when I was elected to my panel on its office, there was an article in the newspaper about it, and I must have had every teacher I've ever had or presently have come up to me and congratulate me and say, Mary, we're really proud of you. You're going to do a great job. And that made me feel really good inside that they took the pride in me and knew that I had the responsibility to accomplish that. And I really think that they were truly sincere, and that made me feel really good.
You won't find a January blouse here at Heritage Buick Mazda. What you will find are some of the most exciting deals of the year. Take home this 88 Buick Skyhawk Custom Coupe for only $169.59 per month. Front-wheel drive is great for snow. Forget the blouse with this little red beauty. $59.94 will buy you a Mazda B2200 two-wheel drive truck. Heritage has it all. A warm, comfortable showroom, low prices. Definitely no January blouse. Come back here.
How long does it usually take to have your income tax return prepared? A week? 2 weeks? Even longer? In most cases, you will have it ready to send the very same day when you take it to Sharp Income Tax Service. Sharp is locally owned and operated. Get your maximum refund plus fast, friendly, professional service at Sharp Income Tax Service. Sterling Plaza, Peoria. Town Center 1, East Peoria.
You can be a fleet buyer at John Deere's Ford Yugo.
Once a year only, we sell every car, truck, and van at a factory direct fleet buyer's price. Escorts and Festiva are only $59.95, and you can even buy a Yugo for only $25 down. We purchased every car, truck, and van possible, so you can save thousands, just like the commercial fleet buyers do. But it's only for a limited time at John Deere's Ford Yugo.
Which
Central Illinois law firm has over 65 years combined experience in personal injury cases.
Goldfine and Bull.
Which law firm represents the largest number of personal injury victims?
Goldfine and Bull.
Which law firm is the leader in personal injury and workers' compensation awards?
Goldfine and Bull.
What's the first thing you should do if you're injured?
Call Goldfine and Bull. There's no charge to discuss your case. Don't settle for less.
The Stan Albeck Show, Sundays, only on WEEK.
Welcome back to Carver Arena.
Here at halftime, they'll be beating Indiana State on the upcoming 53-40, and it's also senior day. We've got seven of them here who are saying goodbye to a very special gentleman who wasn't able to see it at the beginning of the ball game, and we thought we'd let you meet some of the people behind the famous faces. Paul's mother, all the way from Nevada, Oklahoma. So we'll be talking about him in a minute. And Gail, you've come a long way, and so has Donna. This is quite a trip for you.
Yeah, well, it means a lot to me to kind of plan.
Has really matured as a young man, hasn't he?
Are you happy with
your dad here at Bradley? That must be a real thrill for you.
We picked Bradley along with Donald, and it was a long way from home, but I'm glad that he chose Bradley.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you. Nice to have you here in Peoria. And a couple of people on this side, it's from the Golden Road Trip, but down to Peter, Ron and Bert. You haven't had to go very far to see your son play. You've seen him play right here close to home. How about for you, Bob,
recruited by Lute Olson at Iowa, and then again when he went to Arizona, and then he talked about going to South Carolina, but I guess it was very important for him to go close to home.
Yeah, talked a lot going to Colorado.
We were talking just a little bit before the game. It seems like
we've started with all of our boys about 72 and we probably wouldn't have got to see a third of the games if he'd went a little further away to school.
I've got to ask you, how many miles have you been walking over 4 years? Because you guys go to just about every game.
I have no idea. We've been to every game this year except North Carolina.
Let me ask you about this three-point shot. This seems to be made for Trevor. How much did he practice that as a young man?
Well, of course, I know him. It's not like him, but he's been doing good, as everybody knows, and he's used to seeing from that front, and that's where he's always shot from.
From the man at Bradley, and I'm sure that you both are very proud of him.
Yes, we are.
It was very touching to see that. Thank you very much.
We'll be back here at halftime
in just a minute. Bradley leading right now, 53-40.
It's been coming for months, and it's finally here. Huber Lincoln Mercury Mercury Subaru and Huber Diamond Dodge's first anniversary celebration sale. Through Monday night, choose from over 200 new cars and trucks, all clearance price, all with no cash down.
Like this 88 Mercury Tracer with Aaron Moore, $189 a month, no cash down. Limited edition Cougars, $259 a month, no cash down.
Don't miss clearance prices and no cash down. Plus, register to win a free Subaru Justy or $5,400 cash. See you today at Huber Lincoln Mercury Mercury Subaru and Huber Diamond Dodge across from College Hills Mall in Bloomington.
Design Furniture and Systems have created efficient offices for hundreds of Tri-County businesses. From interior design and space planning to product selection, coordination, and accent pieces to their experienced service department's final installation. No matter what your space or budget, Design Furniture and Systems can make your office more efficient through space saver systems like this mobile storage unit or color-coded filing systems. Design Furniture and Systems, Downstate's fastest growing interior design company with additional sales offices in Bloomington and LaSalle, Peru.
One leading corn soil insecticide says to apply in furrow for the best rootworm control. And leading universities say you get the best rootworm control with a banded application. We agree, because a T-band application of Lorspan 15G insecticide gives you the best of both. In furrow application and banded, you get the best control of rootworms and other damaging insects. T-band Lorspan 15G. That's corn security.
You won't find a January Blahs here at Heritage Buick Mazda. What you will find are some of the most exciting deals of the year. Take home this 88 Buick Skyhawk Custom Coupe for only $169.59 per month. Front wheel drive is great for snow. Forget the Blahs with this little red beauty. $59.94 will buy you a Mazda B2200 two-wheel drive truck. Heritage has it all. A warm, comfortable showroom, low prices. Definitely no January Blahs. Come back here.
Experience the excitement of the early days of television with a program 35 years in the making. Join the News 25 family for a special hour of memories reliving WEEK's first 35 years. We'll look back at what the area was like when TV first appeared, examine TV's impact on Central Illinois, and reminisce with popular personalities that made WEEK the area's most watched station. Bill Houlihan, Christine Zack, and Tom McIntyre host WEEK, 25 at 35, Monday at 8.
Matlock at a special time today at 4:30.
We have been very fortunate to have benefactors in the Bradley community to endow the arts at Bradley with the funds to bring in the leading artists on the cutting edge of American art, theater, music, to work directly with the faculty and students here at Bradley. And in the 2.5 years I've been here, we have had Richard Thomas, the television star. We have had Jeffrey Holder, the great Broadway choreographer and writer and actor. This year we're bringing in Linda Lavin, who just won the Tony Award on Broadway. We have had directors from television and from film, and a full spectrum of artists that has been absolutely crucial to the success here at Bradley and makes it unique and gives it an advantage over any other university its size in the study of the arts.
Not only recognizing outstanding performance on the court, but also contributing to the Bradley University General Scholarship Fund. And so today I'm pleased to present this year's installment of $8,000 in a check to the Bradley University Scholarship Fund to Mr. Ferguson. On behalf of North Point Video, we're pleased to be part of the Bradley basketball team.
On behalf of Bradley University, I'd like to thank North Point Video. This money will go a long way to help the Bradley Athletic Scholarship Fund, and we really appreciate it, Mike, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Ron. Thank you, Ron, and how about a nice hand for North Point Video and their generous donation to Bradley University.
It is halftime here at Carver Arena. And Bradley leads Indiana State 53-40, and let's take a statistical look at the first half, if we can. As we compare the two clubs, the Braves shooting 56% from the field. Part of that is Hersey Hawkins' 7 of 9 performance so far. The Braves have out-rebounded the Indiana State 21-17. And the Sycamores have turned it over two more times. As for individuals in the ball game, Rob Vickers with 12 points. He is 4 for 6 on threes. He is also the Sycamores' leading rebounder with 4. And Vickers is only 5'10". Richie Adderley has 10 points. Eddie Bird has 7. And you see Lyles, Cheatham, and Akinola rounded out. Bird and Akinola with 3 fouls apiece. And Campbell has 3 as well. None of the Braves in dire foul trouble except for Jerry Thomas, who has 3. Hersey Hawkins with 21 points. Anthony Manuel with 9. Luke Jackson with 7. By the way, the Hawk is Radley's leading rebounder with a total of 7 boards. And so that's the way things size up at halftime with the Braves on top, 53-40, but at one stage they led 41-18. That was with 7:53 to play in the first half. And in those final 7 minutes and 53 seconds, the Sycamores outscored the Braves 22-12. So Indiana State, with Eddie Bird on the bench, has been able to rally just a bit and get themselves in a position where they could make this a ball game in the second half. About rebounds at the Indiana State 21-17. And the Sycamores have turned it over 2 more times. As for individuals in the ball game, Rob Vickers with 12 points. He is 4 for 6 on threes. He is also the Sycamores' leading rebounder with 4. And Vickers is only 5'10". Richie Adderley has 10 points. Eddie Bird has 7. And you see Lyles, Cheatham, and Akinola rounded out. Bird and Akinola with 3 fouls apiece. And Campbell has 3 as well. None of the Braves in dire foul trouble except for Jerry Thomas, who has 3. Hersey Hawkins with 21 points. Anthony Manuel with 9. Luke Jackson with 7. By the way, the Hawk is Radley's leading rebounder with a total of 7 boards. And so that's the way things size up at halftime with the Braves on top, 53-40, but at one stage they led 41-18. That was with 7:53 to play in the first half. And in those final 7 minutes and 53 seconds, the Sycamores outscored the Braves 22-12. So Indiana State, with Eddie Bird on the bench, has been able to rally just a bit and get themselves in a position where they could make this a ball game in the second half. Manuel, Hawkins, Trippi, Jones, and Luke Jackson out on the floor for the second half of the game. It is the final regular season home game, but not the final game. That'll be Monday at Southern Illinois, and we'll televise on WEEK. That one starts at 9 o'clock and will be preceded by an hour-long special on 35 years of television broadcasting, WEEK, 25 at 35. The Sycamores start the second half with the ball as Adderley holds it against Hawkins. Here's Vickers, who has 4 three-pointers.
You can see what Indiana State has in mind. They're going to burn a little clock here.
Eddie Bird in the game, but not back in the scorebook. Here's Manuel. Tried to make the fancy pass to Hawkins. He recovered the ball anyway. Inside, Luke Jackson with the jumper. And he gets the Braves out to a 15-point lead.
Good job that time by Luke. First he cut through the lane, and Luke just followed him and posted up there just shy of the free throw line, turned around and knocked it down.
Vickers, another 3. That's 5.
5 for 7 from out there.
Hawkins puts the dribble down on Adderley, drives against Campbell, shoots over him and misses. A fight for the rebound, won by Greg Jones, and you can count the basket. So Jones, who had 4 in the first half, will have 7 if he hits on the back end of the three-point play.
Percy took the ball to the bucket, and Greg just kind of faded over to the other side of the lane and did a good job there on the weak side rebounding.
Ron Green, his 3rd year at Indiana State,
and every year he's had to start over.
Greg didn't hit anything that time, except the backboard.
Adderley banged up, so he'll take a walk over to the Indiana State bench to get patched up.
They met for the first time at Bradley's MIT appearance in 1982. They're seen in Section 2.
Bird with the goggles.
Wes and Linda Reed. Please stand and receive appreciation to the Bradley fans.
And as soon as Adderley is ready to go, we'll be ready to go here. You would think that Eddie Bird's favorite athlete would be Larry, but it's not. It's Carl Yastrzemski. He doesn't even play anything anymore.
It's pretty interesting, though, that they both played in the same city.
That might have had something to do with it. I think Eddie got a free pass to a few Red Sox games. I'll tell you what, if my brother paid my tuition to school, he'd be my favorite everything. Luke Jackson on the block. I think Larry could do that with his meal money, don't you think?
I would imagine.
Hawkins inside, called for the charge. Third foul on Hersey. And the Sycamores within 14, close enough to get an argument from Stan Allback.
He didn't have too much to say in the first half. Things went along pretty well.
Hawkins on the steal, makes amends, picks up the loose ball in front of Allback and launches a jumper from Manuel. Eddie Bird collects the carom. Vickers stumbles, almost fell, but he kept the dribble going. Bird fakes the three, does again, passes to Campbell. Here's Bird, no good. Campbell on the rebound, reverse layup, rolls off the rim, and Willie Sanchez puts the whistle to work against Bradley. Let's see who it's against. Trevor Trimpe. And that's two on him.
Weak side rebound that time by Deion Campbell. Just couldn't get this one to go in.
Bird wants that three-pointer, but Greg Jones won't give it to him. You don't see Greg play out that far very often. And a traveling call against Indiana State. Mike Brady gets an earful from Stan Allback as the Braves bring the ball up the floor. Hawk shoots off the pass. Luke Jackson with the follow. Double digits for Luke Jackson. He has 11.
10 seconds.
It was 10 seconds and the turnover. In fact, it was 13 seconds. There were 32 seconds left on the shot clock. And that's what Stan Allback is telling Mike Brady right now. Hawkins spins, still in deep trouble. Out to Manuel, now to Trimpe for the bomb. Yes. Lead up to 19. Bird double team stolen by Hawkins. He drives the bucket and he's fouled by Bird. Bird never had enough time to get position and the Hawk took advantage of it. And that's four fouls on Eddie Bird. We'll be back in a minute.
Has midwinter cabin fever been breathing down your neck? Well, if it hasn't, the IRS soon will. Don't let it get the best of you. Spend your refund now while the savings are hot during Team Electronics Cabin Fever Sale. Big savings on the best in audio and video and more. Free basic install on car stereos, free delivery on stereo systems during the Cabin Fever Sale.
Discover the difference.
The Cabin Fever Sale is going on right now at Team Electronics in the Metro Center.
Brown Sporting Goods has hundreds of super fitness values to help you shape up and save. The Weslo Relay 880 treadmill has all the most wanted features, including variable speed adjustment, a 10-function work center that includes time, speed, distance, and a 2-function pulse monitor, plus a gas-assisted incline adjustment. A complete system for only $499.88. You save $200. For fitness, it's Brown's.
Brown Sporting Goods, for the games you play.
Welcome to Peoria Toyota Volvo.
I suppose you're going to try to sell me a new Toyota. I'm busy and I don't need a lot of chit-chat. The first thing you're going to tell me is that Toyota's reputation for quality is legendary. And then you're going to tell me Toyota's high-tech engineering makes driving so much more enjoyable. And I'm sure you'll talk about the Toyota touch when it comes to service. Will you talk me into it? I'll take it.
Who could ask for anything more?
A Peoria success story, tonight on American Dreamers.
Tomorrow, Sports World presents Super Tennis at 1, followed by NBC College Basketball at 3, as Duke plays at Georgia Tech. It's all here, beginning at 1 o'clock tomorrow on WEEK, NBC's Sports World.
Thanks, Marv. Gary Thomas's father finally got into town and made the game. He was recognized a little bit earlier in the ball game.
And that's the gentleman that you saw up on our screen a moment ago. Luke Jackson hustles to retain possession. Here's Manuel. Fouled. No, Luke Jackson fouled Darren Lyles away from the ball. Ron Burkholz said he gave him the elbow. That's three fouls on Luke.
Oh. They started pushing as soon as the ball came in bounds.
Ron Cheatham back into the game for Indiana State. He's got 4 points.
Stan Albeck wants to keep the pressure on here.
Bird is back on the bench. You never hear them say that in Boston.
Not too often.
Here's Cheatham wide open.
Nailed a three to send that Southern game into overtime the other night.
Jones shooting over Cheatham. And Lyles is there with a rebound. Indiana State, seems like all of their players shoot these high arching jumpers as the Sycamores turn it over. Hawkins down the lane, lays it up, it's good, it counts, and he was fouled on the play.
We see it every game. Lyles tries to get down there and set up and take a charge. Watch Hersey find the gap between Vickers and Lyles rather than picking up a charging foul. He just slides right through him.
Great body control. And that's the third foul on Rob Vickers, their three-point bomber. I'm sorry, the first on Vickers, the third team foul. Just over 15 minutes to play. Here's Hatterley in the backcourt. They get it over with a second to spare. Although apparently our count is much different than the officials. And Dave Phillips, who's the supervisor of officials in the Valley, told me before the season started that the reason the officials don't use the shot clock as a gauge for the 10-second violation is because they're not always sure it starts exactly when it should.
Yeah, and they're keeping the count themselves.
Here's Cheatham with a three. That's a couple in a row by him. He has 10 points, and it's a 16-point ball game. Hawkins on the baseline over Campbell, no good. Sycamore's trying to cut it within 14, but Adderley throws it off the leg of Trevor Trimpe. And that'll put a new 45 seconds on the shot clock and give the Sycamores the ball on the baseline. or make it the sideline in front of the Indiana State bench. And it goes to Vickers, a bounce to Campbell. Braves led at 1 point by 23. That was in the first half. Here's Adderley. Everything got that finger roll that he puts up.
I thought for sure he was in trouble when he went in there against Luke, but he somehow maneuvered his way and got the ball in.
Bad pass by Trimpe. Vickers picks him off. Cheatham.
Oh,
almost walked. Luke picks up the rebound. Alley-oop to Luke. Stolen by Campbell. Bradley coaches thought it should have been a foul. Here's Vickers. To Campbell inside, now to Adderley, and I think they're passing it around a little more than they have to. Thomas in, Trimpe out. Alathimi Akinola takes a spot on the floor, and Eddie Byrd comes back into the ball game. Darren Lyles and Deion Campbell will go to the bench. Indiana State already with a game's worth of turnovers.
Yeah, it's been a little sloppy at times, but Bradley's pressure has caused a lot of those.
Donald Powell in the ball game for the Braves. And another whistle inside, and this one is on Indiana State. That'll be the third on Richie Adderley.
Adderley applauded that call.
Sort of mocked Willie Sanchez there, and Sanchez showed that he didn't have a short fuse. Hawkins on the rebound, couldn't get it to fall.
I guess Adderley's argument could be, how else do you expect me to guard this guy?
Here's Eddie Byrd, Larry's younger brother, with the pass to Vickers. Back to Byrd, guarded by the Hawk. This is a game for the Audubon Society with the Sycamores here. And Byrd scores and is fouled. Not sure I saw where that foul occurred.
The call came on the second swipe he made from behind, looked like.
They called it against Luke Jackson, and so Luke will leave, and Paul Wilson will take his place. Jackson sits down with 11. Byrd with 9, Byrd with 10. And it's an 11-point ball game. That's as close as it's been since the early going.
Well, Ron Green got those two technicals in the first minute of the game, and it's never been close since.
Indiana State has had a couple of chances to get within 9, but they haven't been able to do it. Alathimi Akinola with his fourth foul. And you can see that the Braves will soon be in the bonus. Here's Powell. Akinola saves it. Out of bounds. Adderley goes out with it. He's already banged up his elbow, and now it looks like he hurt his knee, too. In fact, you may have noticed some blood on the front of Hersey Hawkins' jersey. And from Adderley's arm, he's still bleeding.
And Hawk's jersey has got a few red stains on it. I think they're making a little bit of contact on the inside.
Looks like one of Bob Fleming's old jerseys.
Or his new ones.
65-54 with 12:20 to play in the ball game. Bradley on top. Wilson tried to put him up a little higher. Campbell with the rebound. Hawk with another near steal. And now Willie Charlie Sanchez and Ron Burkholz talk it over.
I think Ron Burkholz might have got caught up in a little of the contact there.
One of the biggest fellas on the floor. I'm not sure I'd want to run into him. And now they can't decide where they want to take it out from. And they're going to conference with the two head coaches. Don Green didn't want to come to half court. He was afraid he was going to get a technical.
He's got a great sense of humor. The man handles this well. I mean, the guy's 3-10 in the conference, 7-19. They've had injury after injury. Lost a fine young player last week. But he can still smile. He's still a friendly guy, and somehow he manages to find some humor in a little bit of everything.
Well, he's been successful everywhere he goes. There's Richie Adderley doing some first aid on his elbow. Ron Green's been successful everywhere he's been, and he'll be successful at Indiana State, but he has had three extremely difficult years at Indiana State and practically three entirely different teams to work with.
Well, with names like Bird and Elijah, you got to figure things are going to get a little bit better. It's not Larry and Akeem, but not bad.
Again, the Braves thought that they had held Indiana State in the backcourt for 10 seconds, but didn't get the call. Now a bad pass by Campbell, and the Hawk takes the lead pass from Wilson. 26 points for Hersey Hawkins.
Great outlet pass that time by Paul Wilson.
Again, the shot clock says 34 seconds, but they don't get the 10-second call. Here's Lyles with the terrible shot. Powell clears the boards to Manuel, to the basket for Wilson, but Manuel charged. And they call it a push, but you can take your pick. It's on the Braves, who lead by 13, and that's the first foul on Anthony. So while Anthony pulls himself together, we'll take a timeout.
KBL Design Center has an offer you can't refuse. Take advantage of our storewide clearance sale and save up to 60% on top quality name brand lamps and lighting fixtures. At KBL Design Center, you'll find 1,500 fixtures on display, including Stifel, Quizzell, Crystal Clear, Thomas, and PD West. And during our storewide clearance, all lampshades are an additional 25% off. You'll also save on Butler Specialty Furniture, the perfect touch to any room. Shop early for best selection during our storewide clearance sale at KBL Design Center, 4700 North Brandywine Drive, Peoria.
Too cheap. Now my accountant thinks we're selling cars, trucks, and vans too cheap.
Special purchase?
He thinks I'm crazy for buying the inventory of an out-of-business Chicago Oldsmobile dealer.
Below invoice?
He can't believe we're selling all those Oldsmobiles below factory invoice.
No money down?
And we're selling 88 cars and trucks for no money down.
Really?
Drive home in a bargain from Uftring Chevy Olds, Central Illinois' number one Chevy Olds dealer. But hurry before they're
sold.
We know what matters.
If you missed Matlock on Tuesday night due to our technical difficulties, it can be seen immediately following today's ball game on WEEK. And our next Bradley telecast is Monday night from Carbondale as the Braves play Southern Illinois. The Salukis are fighting for a spot in the upper division. We'll be live in Carbondale at 9 o'clock on Monday, our last telecast of the regular season.
Indiana State gave them a whale of a ball game Thursday night.
Now the student section is now helping the officials count off to 10 seconds as the Sycamores try to bring it into the front court. We have 11 minutes to play, and the Braves lead 67-54. Here's Eddie Bird. Bounces inside to Lyles. Threw it off the side of the backboard. Powell picks up the loose ball. Ahead to Manuel. Braves by 13. Wilson at the arc. Inside, Hawkins goes up, and he's fouled by Vickers. That's the second on little Rob Vickers, which the program lists at 5'10". But I wouldn't take money on that.
maybe in two or three pair of socks and his high tops. There you see the blood all over Hersey Hawkins' jersey.
It's Adderley.
Richie Adderley.
Yeah. That's not Hawkins who's bleeding. That's Adderley.
Somehow that blood from his elbow got on there. I'm not sure how that happened.
Yeah, and it's amazing that we didn't hear any whistles after that got there. But
here we go.
Hawkins adding to his single season scoring record. Has 28 points. That gives him 926 for the season, so 874 for 1,000. And I think with the Missouri Valley Tournament coming up and a game on Monday, he's going to do it. The first Bradley player ever to score 1,000 points in one season. And a foul on the play. Willie Sanchez getting good work out of that whistle today. It's the third against Donald Powell.
Donald better be careful. He's let Willie Sanchez know what he thinks of the last couple of calls that have gone against him. Contact there.
Misses the first free throw. Lyles was as big of a football star in high school as he was basketball. He was recruited by Auburn.
A tight end and a defensive end. And that shows when you see him go to work underneath.
Here are the Braves on the run and the Hawks. But he's called for the foul after the basket. They'll count the basket, but he's called for the foul after the basket. And that's four fouls on Hawkins, and Stan Albeck disagrees.
Either that or he wants rain. And a little bit of a rain dance on the sidelines.
Fouls has only fouled out of one game this season. Lyles hits the free throw. An explosive dunk. You could go either way with that. And Lyles gets him back with the two free throws.
No question about which way that man would go with that call.
Here's the Hawk again. No good, and it bounces up over behind the backboard. That'll turn it over. And as the Braves came down the floor to work the ball, Stan did a little work on Willie Sanchez, one of his favorite Missouri Valley Conference officials. Here's Adderley, finds the lane and takes it, but he misses the layup. Braves by 15. Here's Manuel. A bounce to Jerry Thomas. Inside Donald. Pushes it up over Lyles, but misses by a mile. Here's Bird with the three. Got it. His brother once hit 11 of those in a row at the three-point shooting contest. And he comes up with a big one to cut it to a 12-point Bradley lead. There are 9:23 to play, but the Sycamores have to make their move now. Manuel with the hanging banker. And it's up to 13 again. They get 14.
Big shot there by Anthony to try and stem the Indiana State Tide here.
Well, the Sycamores have played the second half with Bradley's every step of the way. They were down to the Braves by 13 at the half. Cheatham at the foul line being fronted by Wilson. Loose ball out of bounds, and it belongs to Bradley.
They really had trouble hanging onto the ball.
Here's Manuel cutting down the lane, passing to Thomas, who misses.
Carroll walks the tightrope. Hawkins with the loose ball, batted away, gets it back, and Thomas is there to score on the rebound. Darren Lyles helped Jerry Thomas up. Most teams want to get back before the Braves do, and Lyles helped Jerry Thomas up. Go ahead, play defense.
Well, Indiana State's going to take their time anyway. It doesn't matter.
Now, they don't have a good record, but they are good Samaritans. Powell on the block, but the Sycamores get it back. Here's Lyles. And he's starting to become a force inside of this game.
I think we've seen more bodies on the floor in this game than we have all year.
Hawk with the acrobatic move in the lane to draw the foul, and that is something he has done oh so well in the last few ball games. Well, he's done it well all year, but he just seems to be getting more and more proficient at it.
Well, at the DePaul game, he got banged around a little bit, took an elbow to the ribs, and was really sore for a few games. And I think once that wore off, he really started to go into the paint a little bit more.
He averages 35 and a half a game. This will give him 32. And it gives the Braves a 14-point lead with 7:34 to play.
There goes Doris, my next-door neighbor and practically my best friend. Every time I see her, I can't help but think of her accident. She was in the hospital for weeks, and on top of that, once she got out, she had to hire somebody to help her with the kids, and none of it was her fault. If it weren't for Joe Jansen, she would have been wiped out. He knew exactly how to help her. It was a horrible time for her, but thanks to Jansen, money was the least of her worries. I sure don't mean to look on the dark side, but it's nice to know there's a Jansen out there.
Hi, this is Stan Allback, and this is my man for the best car deals in the Peoria area. Bruce Sowers at Valdi Ford and Valdi Lincoln Mercury.
Thanks, Stan. We've got the best selection of new and used cars and trucks at the lowest prices right here at Valdi Ford and Valdi Lincoln Mercury. If you think about it, why would you want to go anywhere else? Come in and join the Valdi team today.
Bradley and Valdi, the two hottest teams in Central Illinois.
And remember, if he can't beat your best deal, he'll give you the car free. Just tell him Stan sent you.
Diane buys her dream home on Cheers.
Our director today is Tom Opperman. Our statistician is Perry Cole. And our executive producer is Sue Disman, who is home today, feeling under the weather. Had a note from her doctor who said she couldn't come to the ball game. So we hope she is feeling better soon. There's Alafimi Akinola, and there's Stan Allback, still not too pleased with the work of the Zebras.
But give Willie Sanchez some credit. He's taking a lot of backlash from players and coaches today, and he takes it pretty well. A lot of guys get steamed and call a team.
They're running out of time. They didn't call it again. We keep checking that shot clock. It can't be wrong every time. Here's Vickers driving. Blocked by Powell again. That's four. Campbell. Flying up there like a cat. I think he had a finger in the eye, too.
Yeah, he did.
Hawkins in the lane with the hang time. Here's Jerry Thomas. He's fouled from behind by Bird. He's out of the ballgame. And he congratulates Hersey Hawkins. A classy move before he leaves. In fact, he just congratulates everybody on the floor. Eddie Bird fouls out with 13 points. And he gets a big hand from the crowd here at Carver Arena. We're going to see a lot more from him.
Well, A lot of people want to compare him to his brother Larry. There's only going to be one Larry Bird, but this guy's going to be a good player. Might be the newcomer of the year in the Valley. Certainly he is a prime candidate for that award.
Yeah, he'll get a fight from Bob Harstad for that award, the kid at Creighton, but they're both pretty good. Thomas at the line, misses the first. 6:41 now to play. Bradley had 53 at halftime. Manuel trying to steal the ball, almost did, and he runs over Brad E. Lee.
He looks like a pyramid when he lays down with that nose.
Schnaz, only Jimmy Durant again.
Yeah, but he keeps smiling, doesn't
That's
he?
Right. That is the goofiest looking thing. Richie Adderley scores. He has 14 points.
Hawk tried to return the favor that time, tried to pick up a charge, and got a no-call that time. Stan's just smiling over here.
A turnover. And then a recovery by Manuel. The Braves have hustled all the way. They have never let down, despite getting up with big leads. Hawkins is fouled by Adderley. That's four on him, so he's in danger of leaving the ball game. And the Hawk will go to the free throw line with 32 points. And so far at the free throw line tonight, our statistician Perry Cole tells us that the Hawk is 10 out of 13. He had 18 free throws in that 63-point performance against Detroit.
Seems like Hawk goes to the line and invariably misses the first couple of free throws, or goes two for three, two for four, and then hits a lot in a row. He doesn't miss late in the game.
It also seems like he scores more points in the second half of a game when it's on the line than he does in the first. Campbell with the jumper, rims the basket. Rebound to Wilson, and the Braves come running out of there with a 15-point lead. Hawkins in the lane, backing in, he walked, no call. Thomas has it slapped out of bounds, and the Braves will have it.
Well, they've gone from making the charge call or the block to not making it at all right now.
The Braves with Hawkins, Thomas, Paul Wilson, and Donald Powell on the floor. And Adderley, I don't think he has a part of the anatomy left that isn't sore, limps off. He has really had a ball game today. He's going to feel it tomorrow.
Well, that's been the story for Indiana State this year. A lot of injuries, guys banged around, banged up.
You know, earlier this year, the people in Terre Haute started to criticize the basketball team and head coach Ron Green. The players didn't like that. They very much like Ron Green, and they know that things have been tough for them this year. And so after one of their ball games, they decided, not Green, the players decided that they would shut the locker room to the media, sort of as a protest, because even the fans at the Holman Center were heaping verbal abuse on them and Coach Ron Green. And then the next day they held a press conference to display their displeasure over the treatment that the coach was getting. Back underway, Donald Powell scores, and he'll go to the free throw line with a chance at a three-point play.
Donald Lewis has been doing most of the afternoon, taking it right to Darren Lyles.
Those were his first points of the second half. And the lead is 18. The Braves put the pressure on anyway. three men in the backcourt trying to force the turnover. Cheatham, front court to Campbell. Hook shot, no good. Lyles doing a good job on the boards. Follows it in.
Lyles.
Darren Lyles, a 6'9", 235-pounder from Town Creek, Alabama. Emmanuel answered. 13 for Anthony. He's hit his average. And a steal. Wilson takes it off and deflects it. Oh, with the jam, but the foul is on Wilson before Donald could stroke it home, and it'll turn it over to Indiana State with 4:45 to play.
You could kind of sense that one coming. Ball likes to take the ball right to the hoop. Jerry Thomas gets in trouble sometimes doing that when there's a man set up down low.
Akinola will check back into the ball game. He has scored only 2 points, and you know you're having trouble when your starting center has only 2 points. The Braves had the same problem against Tulsa on Thursday when Luke Jackson only scored a pair of points.
Akinola played well down in Terre Haute. He had 8 points and seven rebounds. Just about 25 minutes really kept Luke from being a factor in that ball game.
This is Ron Cheatham at the free throw line. Loose ball, and Paul Wilson checks out some of the season tickets. It'll be Indiana State's. It has never been close, although the Sycamores have had opportunities to get it within nine. They're down 17 right now. Thomas.
Jerry Thomas, a good job of avoiding the charge that time. Hanging on to the rim a little bit extra there to keep himself from flying into the body.
Campbell on the layup as the Sycamores work a basket in a hurry, but the Braves are right back at him, and Wilson slams it. The Richter scale has been in use rather often lately. Lyles from the baseline, no good. Manuel on the rebound. Braves by 19, trying to go up 21. Maybe 22. And Hawkins is fouled. Looks like it's against Deion Campbell. And that'll send him back to the free throw line with 34 points and a chance to build on it.
Well, during the last timeout, Stan Albeck admonished the Braves to do some more rebounding. He said if Hersey doesn't rebound, we don't get any. There you see Hersey going to the boards. Very well following up Anthony Manuel.
He's leading the team in rebounding with 7.4 per game. Back tap to midcourt by a Sycamore player, so the Braves' Anthony Manuel not in jeopardy of turning it over as he recovers it in the backcourt. Here's Powell against two blue jerseys. Gets his own rebound and lays it in. He's in double digits.
Really good second effort that time by Donald. The pressure of the two guys down low really forced him to adjust his shot, but he followed it well.
Wilson clears the boards ahead to Jerry Thomas. Guess what's going to happen here? I thought we were going to see a dunk with Donald and Thomas racing down the floor. And Anthony Manuel has called for the foul, his second, with 2:57 to play in the ball game. And the Braves back up by 21, so Bradley will run its winning streak to 7 in a row, and that's the longest of the season. As Deion Campbell steps up to the charity stripe. We're going to see Steve Bayless check in. The Braves try to reach 100.
And the Hawk goes to the basket and is fouled. Here's Steve Bayless, the freshman from Chillicothe, Ohio. He'll take the place of Jerry Thomas, who goes out with 12 points. That foul on Campbell fouls him out of the game, and so that's why we're waiting. We're waiting for Ron Green to put in a replacement. It's going to be the much-abused Richie Adderley. Has the knee brace on, he's torn his elbow open, has tape on his thumb, both legs are sore.
Sounds like he can make the All-Madden team, doesn't it?
I'm not sure he wants to do any work up on the roof. Hawk has reached his average with that free throw. And we've reached a point in the game where we must take a timeout. Bradley's going to win. It's just a matter of how many they're going to win by.
Illinois, the savings are right here today at S&K Chevrolet. And before you spend too much for a Ford or Pontiac, well, get yourself on in here to S&K. Check out the new 88 Corsica. Front wheel drive, four-door comfort, and more. And now at S&K, take your pick of the whole group. Base price reduced to just $89.99. What color do you want? Hey, with factory cash back and special option package savings, you could save as much as $2,600 on the new Corsica you've been wanting. That's what they're talking about today at the top of the town. S&K Chevrolet in Peoria.
Design Furniture and Systems have created efficient offices for hundreds of Tri-County businesses. From interior design and space planning to product selection, coordination, and accent pieces to their experienced service department's final installation. No matter what your space or budget, Design Furniture and Systems can make your office more efficient through space saver systems like this mobile storage unit or color-coded filing systems. Design Furniture and Systems, Downstate's fastest growing interior design company with additional sales offices in Bloomington and La Salle, Peru.
On our next show, Roxanne Pulitzer.
Join Stan Albeck tomorrow morning at 11 when he'll pick his All-Americans and his All-Missouri Valley Conference team. Take a look at Bradley's buzzer beaters and talk with Bradley's Sports Information Director, Joe Delfonso. The Stan Albeck Show tomorrow morning at 11 right here on WEEK. I guess Jay Shell couldn't make it. He's in the ballgame now, though, along with Steve Bayless. And the Hawk hangs around with 36 points. Shell, the freshman from Stevens Point, Wisconsin. The last 2 minutes plus, as the Braves try to reach the 100-point barrier.
Sophomore Mike Cash will get a chance to try and help out. He's ready to check in at the scorer's table.
With the jumper. Hawkins there for the rebound. He had 7 in the first half, so he must be in double figures by now. Jayshell.
Get used to watching that.
Akinola holds it high. Ron Green probably said, just take 45 seconds off the clock and let's get out of here. A minute 25 to play.
Vickers with a foot on the line hits. So it's a two-point basket. But still a very comfortable 23-point lead. Steve Bayless goes baseline. And he turns it over. And Hersey Hawkins leads the ball game with 36 points as he's congratulated by his teammates on another great effort. Scott Beckew and Mike Cash into the ball game. So except for Paul Wilson, it's an all-freshman lineup out there for the Braves. And we're inside a minute. The Braves will win the ball game and claim a share of the Missouri Valley Conference title.
Oh, let's get a dead ball. Bruce Mordini waiting to check in.
Here's Vickers. Drives, passes. Akinola lays it up. And a foul on the play, and that'll bring Bruce Mordini into the ball game, the senior from Highland Park. And Paul Wilson is out. So the bench has been empty.
Now, Len Bertolini was wanting to get in before the game.
Well, I think he's still wearing that support on his foot, and I'm not sure he could play anyway. But
he is, but he wants in there. Good to see Bruce Mordini get to play in the last regular season game. He's worked so hard and just had the worst luck in the world.
Only his second appearance of the season. I think Ron Green would say he's had the worst luck in the world. Bruce Mordini's had a real difficult 4 years with all the injuries.
Len Bertolini looking down the bench, waiting for that call.
Here's Scott Beckew, lost the ball out of bounds, turns it over to Indiana State. If Tulsa beats Wichita tonight, the Braves will be Missouri Valley champions outright. If Wichita State wins, then the Braves will have to win at Southern on Monday to be sole champions. 20 seconds to play.
The bench would like to see Bruce get a shot here. I don't know if Indiana State's going to let him.
Seconds. And that's it. The game is over, and the Braves have clinched at least a share of a Missouri Valley championship as they run their record to 22-4 and their Missouri Valley Conference record to 11-2. Back in a minute.
Too cheap. Now my accountant thinks we're selling cars, trucks, and vans too cheap.
Big rebates?
He thinks I'm crazy for giving big discounts plus up to $750 rebates on Oldsmobiles.
No money down?
He can't believe we're selling Chevy cars and trucks with up to $600 rebates for no money down.
They don't cost?
And executive demo, $600 below our cost.
Really?
Drive home in a bargain from Uptring Chevy Olds, but hurry before they're
sold!
If you're a computer owner, and who isn't today, here's your support team. CBM. CBM Computer Center. Serving you with the best products, people, and ongoing support. CBM has it all. Quality product, service, and expertise. You won't get sold, then left out in the cold. CBM. All you need to remember about computers.
From the day it opened its doors, Peoria's first and oldest bank has been a symbol of guidance and security. Through good times and bad times, the First National Bank of Peoria has continued to serve the people of our community, offering a wide range of financial opportunities. Whether it be checking, savings, loans, trust services, or retirement plans, you can count on the First for all your banking needs. The First National Bank of Peoria, now serving you at three convenient locations.
Why the big rush?
I've got to get to University Ford.
What's your hurry?
University Ford.
And you?
University Ford. Why is everybody rushing to University Ford? People have discovered this really is the best place to buy a new or used car or truck.
discounts to $1,507 on four-door Escorts. Right now at University Ford.
At University Ford, you're always a winner.
Thanks, David.
Matlock, at a special time today at 4:30.
Bradley 95, Indiana State 74, and our North Point Video Bradley player of the game with 36 points, Percy Hawkins. The Braves are Missouri Valley co-champions, and if Wichita State loses to Tulsa tonight, they'll win the conference outright. Our next broadcast is Monday night at 9, when we'll televise the Braves at Southern Illinois. It starts at 9 o'clock right after WEEK 25 at 35. For Lee Hall and our director Tom Opperman, this is Mark Strauss at Carver Arena. Bradley wins it, 95-74. See you Monday night.
KBL Design.
A lounge or recliner, you can buy a 4.5-inch mini TV for just $9.95. Watch TV in your new Strata Lounge recliner from Cohen's.
Television that dares to challenge.
But don't sit there and keep having babies to stay on welfare. Don't have it.
Television you can feel.
I killed his family. I killed my family. I killed myself.
Television that speaks out.
You're out of your mind. You are really out of your mind.
Let me respond to that.
No, I'm going to finish responding first.
The Oprah Winfrey Show. Weekdays at 3 on WEEK.
On our next show, families reunited after years apart.
Due to tonight's 25 Sports exclusive, The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson will not be seen. News 25 Nightside will be seen immediately following tonight's game.
One, two, three, four.
Southern Illinois is awfully tired of Bradley celebrating at their expense. Percy Hawkins set a school scoring record the last time they met. And tonight, they can wrap up the Valley season in first place. Live, 25 Sports brings you Bradley Basketball. This exclusive telecast is brought to you in part by Coors, the beer with the difference worth tasting. Coors is the one. By Coors Light, there's no slowing down with the silver bullet. By University Ford, where you're always a winner. By Counter, more performance, more consistency. Counter gives you more. By Methodist Medical Center of Illinois. By the Country Company's Insurance. You've got the country behind you. By ICI, makers of Eradicane and Diphenate. And by North Point Video, Audio and Appliance, Peoria and Morton. The Bradley Braves are selfish. They don't want to share the Missouri Valley Conference title with Wichita State. And they won't have to if they beat Southern Illinois tonight here in Carbondale. Hello again, everybody. I'm Mark Strauss, along with Lee Hall. Welcome to SIU Arena and our telecast of Bradley versus Southern Illinois. Well, the Braves are on a 7-game win streak, Lee, and if they make it 8, they will be outright Missouri Valley Conference champion.
Well, Mark, there's no doubt they don't want to share this title with anybody. They said that after the game the other night. And